Jesus Christ. Father, I bless your name as I open my mouth again today in Jesus' name. Father, send forth your word with power. Let your name be glorified. Let it save the souls of the children of men into your kingdom. Let it teach them how to walk in love with their neighbors. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. We are still talking about walking in love with your neighbor. I remember last time before we left off, I was re-emphasizing the fact that as a business person, as a trader, it is contrary to the love of God for you to sell a substandard or spoiled article to your neighbor. God commands that you should not deceive your neighbor. You should not deal falsely with your neighbor. You should not steal from your neighbor. You should not lie to your neighbor. When you sell an article that you know is not good or not good enough or does not meet the required standard, you sell such to your neighbor and you are telling him it is good, it's perfect, it's excellent, you have robbed your neighbor. You have stolen from him because you have made him waste his money because that's not what he wants. You have dealt falsely with him. You have lied to him or her. You're guilty of all these three sins. And if you do not repent, there is no way you can inherit the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Let's go again to Leviticus chapter 19, verse 15. Ye shall do no unrighteousness in judgment. Thou shalt not respect the person of the poor, nor honor the person of the mighty. But in righteousness shalt thou judge thy neighbor. If you are serving as an arbitrator, you are arbitrating between two persons or two groups of persons to settle a dispute or whatever, anything like that. The Bible commands that you must not take sides. Don't side one group of persons because they are richer or they are in great positions of authority. Don't side them against the poor who is low in the society and has no position or has no money. Don't take sides in judgment. God commands that in every occasion you have to serve as an arbitrator. Do not take sides. Do it in righteousness and holiness. If you do not obey this, you are guilty of not walking in love towards your neighbor. Both the group you are siding and the group you are not siding, the group you are siding with and the group you are trying to side against, you are not walking in love with either of them. The people who are guilty and you are siding them, you will never let them repent from their iniquities. And the person who is guiltless and you are not ready to agree that is guiltless, also you have done havoc to that person. So you have done evil to both sides. You are guilty before God. Hallelujah. Don't do that. Let's go to Leviticus chapter 19, verse 16. Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer among thy people, neither shalt thou stand against the blood of thy neighbor. I am the Lord. God does not want you to be gossiping around. When you gossip around, you're a busybody in other people's matters. You go around bad-mouthing people, talking about people's mistakes. It's a sin against God. God does not want you to gossip about anyone. Don't go up and down as a talebearer. Nobody sent you. Hallelujah. You are free to give useful security information to people to save them from danger. If you have such an information, that's a different matter. There is danger somewhere or somebody is a murderer. You want to let them know if this person comes to your house, he can plan to rob your house or kill you. Those are different things. Provided you are sure of your information and you are trying to save your neighbor's life from destruction, that's a different matter. But to just go around gossiping is contrary to the love of God. If someone committed adultery, go to that person and preach to him. Preach to him. He's the one who needs to hear your preaching, not the people who have not committed adultery. Hallelujah. Did you hear that someone's child stole money at school? What you need to do is go to that child who stole money at school and preach to the child. You don't need to go around telling everybody. That's exactly what the Bible says you should not do. Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer among thy people. Nobody sent you. God does not send you. Go and preach to the people who need to hear the preaching. Tell them the wrong they are doing and call them to repentance. That would be a good work before God. But to go about gossiping about people's mistakes and always looking for negative things to say about people, discrediting people, bad-mouthing people, slandering people, is a great sin before God. There is no one who does that who can have any part in the kingdom of Christ and of God. Hallelujah. So, brother, sister, repent and begin to walk in love with your neighbor. Let's go to verse 17. Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart. Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor and not suffer sin upon him. Hallelujah. Don't hate your brother. Don't hate your sister. Don't hate your neighbor. Hatred is evil. There is no one who hates his neighbor who can inherit the kingdom of God. Hate is the opposite of love. God wants you to love and not to hate. Hallelujah. If you see your neighbor doing anything wrong, go to him and tell him. Show him the word of God that reveals that such a thing is wrong. Do not leave your neighbor to continue in wrongdoing. It is contrary to the love of God for you to leave your neighbor and allow your neighbor to continue in wrongdoing without you calling him or her to repentance. God commands that you must surely tell your neighbor what he's doing that is evil, that is bad, that can make him lose the kingdom of God, that can make him end up in the lake of fire. God wants you to preach the word of God to your neighbor concerning all such things to bring him or her to repentance. Hallelujah. Let's go to verse 18. Thou shalt not avenge, nor bear any grudge against the children of thy people, but thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. I am the Lord. Loving your neighbor demands that you do not plan to revenge and don't have grudges against people. If people offend you, you are free to make a report to necessary authorities, but do not take the law into your own hands. While you are planning to revenge, you will become a sinner against God. Leave the judgment to God and don't have grudges against people. If they have offended you, go to them. Tell them their offenses. You never know, they may be ready to apologize and make things right. And if they are not ready to do that, then you can report to the relevant authority. If it's in the church, report to the church authority. If it's in the locality where you live, then report to the authority that presides over that locality. Whether it's a local government, whether it's a street or city government or whatsoever, municipal government, whatever it is, metropolitan government, whatever it is. Do not take the law into your own hands. Hallelujah. Do not have grudges against people. Do not bear grudges. Grudges in your heart will shut you out of the kingdom of God. Do not do evil to yourself. Hallelujah. Let's go to Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. Therefore, all things whatsoever ye would that men should do to you, do ye even so to them. For this is the law and the prophets. That's the summary of all the laws of God. Whatever you do not want people to do to you, do not do such things to others. And whatever you want people to do to you, the exact way in which you want to be treated, the exact way in which you want to be treated, do that to others. Treat people like that. What you want people to do to you, do it to others. What you do not want people to do to you, do not do it to others. Love your neighbor as yourself. Let's go to James chapter 1, verse 27. Pure religion and undefiled before God and the Father is this, to visit the fatherless and widows in their affliction and to keep himself unspotted from the world. Hallelujah. The way God wants you to show love to the fatherless and the widows is to visit them in their affliction. Do not neglect their plight or their suffering. Do not pretend as if you do not know. Do not close your eyes to their hardship. If you do that, you are not walking in love towards the fatherless or the widows. And that makes you a transgressor before God. God has commanded that you visit the fatherless God has commanded that you visit the fatherless and the widows in their affliction. To visit here is not just to go to their homes and sit down for a couple of minutes and drink Coke and drink Fanta, help them spend their money, which is not even enough for their welfare. That's not what God is saying here. He's not talking about merely physical visit. The visitation here is intended to be a visitation of help. You are to be there to alleviate their sufferings, to give to them, to do things that can put an end or contribute to putting an end to their affliction, their suffering, their poverty, their lack and want. This is what God means by visiting the fatherless and the widows. The scripture is not talking about a meaningless visitation in which you just go there and you sit down and you are just chatting and wear them out talking and you do not offer any help. The visit here talks of going there to help, helping to put an end to their afflictions, their poverty, or at least contributing towards this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's read James chapter 1 verse 27 in the CEV. Religion that God accepts as pure and without fault is this: caring for orphans or widows who need help and keeping yourself free from the world's evil influence. That's it. God wants you to care for orphans. God wants you to care for orphans and widows to help to solve their problems. That's one of the ways God wants you to walk in love towards the fatherless and the widows. Hallelujah. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 1, verses 16 and 17. Wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before mine eyes, cease to do evil, learn to do well, seek judgment, relieve the oppressed, judge the fatherless, plead for the widow. Hallelujah. God wants you to stop doing anything evil to anyone. God doesn't approve of you doing any kind of evil to whosoever. So you have to examine your life and make sure all your actions to those who are around you constitute in good and nothing short of good, nothing less than good, nothing different from good. God commands that we sanctify our lives and do not permit any sin to remain in our lives. He says, wash you and make you clean. It's a command from God. Wash and be clean in the blood of Jesus. Be sanctified. Hallelujah. We stop here for today. Father, water the word in the hearts of all the hearers. Let it save their souls into your kingdom. Let it teach them how to walk in love. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen and amen.
This Word of Life program is coming to you through the mouth of God's servant, Oluwabamishi Akinduro of the Triumphant Church of Jesus Christ at 66A Lagos Abeokuta Expressway, Abekoko, Ifo, Ogun State, Nigeria. For further Christian life help, contact 0805-501-6597, 0805-501-6597 by SMS or WhatsApp, or email oluwabamishiakinduro@gmail.com, oluwabamishiakinduro@gmail.com, oluwabamishiakinduro@gmail.com. You can also call 003-842-4075, 003-842-4075, or 003-695-4678, 003-695-4678.
Copies of this short sermon and other longer sermons in English language only can be sent to you free of charge by WhatsApp or email if you request for them.
Join us for this Word of Life program, same day of the week, same time every week. Our Sunday morning service starts at 9 a.m. You are invited to fellowship with us. Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen and amen.